Well, I'm very happy to be here and be meeting with Jack Smith, the executive director of the first White House Conference on the Handicapped, which will take place May 23rd through May 27th in the nation's capital in Washington, D.C. And of course, we've been working a great deal with the Kansas group. There'll be eight delegates, eight alternates, 16 altogether. In our neighboring state of Missouri, there'll be 32 participating in the conference. We've had more than 800 participate in the forums out in our state trying to draft recommendations. And I'm very excited about the White House Conference. I think there are great possibilities and great potential. Jack, give us a few inside looks on what may happen.
Senator, we're excited about it too. And of course, we appreciate your involvement in long-term in the area of the handicapped and helping to establish the legislation for this conference and your interest ongoing. And of course, you're a member of our National Planning and Advisory Council. So you're also responsible there. We've made what we feel is a great national assessment with conferences in every state and territory. And they have truly assessed not only the problems of the handicapped individuals, but the potentials. And we've made a great national assessment and a national awareness now throughout the state conferences and now with a national conference. Our job is one to prioritize what are the important issues and recommendations and then make a report to the President and Congress for future action. We think it's going to move the handicapped ahead in terms of services, really light years ahead. And of course, one of the pressing concerns is the area of attitudes, because truly attitudes affects the problems of housing and transportation, education, employment. How do you see, Senator, that we can break down some of these attitudinal barriers that really separate people from people and people from things?
Well, I think you put your finger on it, Jack. I think we can remove architectural barriers. We make it possible to get in with your wheelchair. We can do a lot of things that to help people with handicaps, regardless of their age and economic status. But there's still an attitude out there. We're sort of a minority group that we've sort of been pushed in the background, and we're coming to the front. Legislation's making it possible. We have affirmative action plans that are going to be implemented now. We're going to, I don't say force people to understand the problem. At least there's going to be a new awareness about the handicapped and about their problems and about jobs, and they're wanting to be part of the mainstream. They're very bright, intelligent people for the most part, and they want to have a piece of the action.
As you know, better than 50% of the delegates coming to the conference will be themselves disabled. 25
That's right.
will represent individuals who really can't speak for themselves, and then 25% from the public and private sector. We think the conference will bring the handicapped into greater independence, dignity, and full participation in all areas of
That's
society.
That's all they really want. They're not
That's
looking
right.
for pity. They're not looking for a government dole of some kind or government handout. They're looking for a part of the action which they properly should have. And I think it's going to be an exciting conference. I'm pleased the President will participate and Mrs. Carter. It's going to be a top-level conference trying to right some wrongs that have been a long time coming.
Senator, I thank you very much for meeting with me today, and we look forward to your participation in the first White House conference ever held May 23rd to the 27th here in Washington. Thank you.
Thanks, Jack.